How does Wharton's description of Mrs. Manstey's view help develop characterization? In this lesson, you will learn how to analyze character development by examining the impact of setting. On May 26, 1891, Edith Wharton's short story, Mrs. Manstey's View, was accepted and published by Scribner's Magazine. At this time, Wharton was 29 and married to a prominent banker, thus putting her in the upper class. Wharton could not be more opposite to her impoverished protagonist, Mrs. Manstey. Mrs. Manstey spends most of her time looking out the back window of her New York rental. When she learns that her neighbor, Mrs. Black, is going to build an addition which will ruin Mrs. Manstey's view, she attempts to discourage her, first through polite appeal and then through arson. In the end, Mrs. Manstey dies, believing that she actually stopped the construction of Mrs. Black's extension. In this lesson, we are focusing on how Edith Wharton develops Mrs. Manstey's character. Character development not only describes how the character grows and changes over the course of the story or novel, but it also approaches how the author makes this happen. In other words, character development describes both the conscious effort of the writer and the effect that effort has on the literature. In order to do this, we are going to follow three steps. First, we will reread a portion of the text and highlight words and phrases that describe the setting. Then, we will ask ourselves, how do these descriptions relate to the character? And finally, we will ask, what does the author want me to think about this character? Let's start by looking on page 3. We are going to focus our attention on the second paragraph, which is different from the preceding paragraphs, because here Wharton establishes the significance of the setting to the character of Mrs. Manstey. Okay, so here is the first half of the paragraph. Mrs. Manstey, in the long hours which she spent at her window, was not idle. She read a little and knitted numberless stockings, but the view surrounded and shaped her life like a sea does a lonely island. Wow, that's a really powerful simile comparing a lonely island to the life of Mrs. Manstey. I'm going to highlight it before reading further. Let's continue. When her rare callers came, it was difficult for her to detach herself from the contemplation of the opposite window washing or the scrutiny of certain green points in a neighboring flower bed, which might or might not turn into hyacinths when she feigned an interest in her visitor's anecdotes about some unknown grandchild. Mrs. Manstey's real friends were the denizens of the yard, the hyacinths, the magnolia, the green parrot, the maid who fed the cats, the doctor who studied late behind the mustard-colored curtains, and the confidant in her tenderer musings was the church spire floating in the sunset. Now, this entire last sentence talks about what she sees outside, the flowers, trees, birds, people, and buildings. I'm going to highlight this because Wharton doesn't just explain what Mrs. Manstey sees when she looks outside. Wharton goes a step further and says that these people and things are her friends. This definitely gives us insight into Mrs. Manstey's character. So now that I've highlighted details about the setting, I'm ready to move on to the second step. I'm going to ask myself, how do these descriptions relate to the character? And in order to answer this, I'm going to look at each section separately. Well, from the first section, I can tell that, like a sea which separates an island from the rest of the world, Mrs. Manstey's obsession with the view out of her room separates her from the outside world. She would rather sit by herself, looking out of her window, than converse with her visitors. This obsession with her view is causing her self-isolation. In the next section, before Wharton lists all of the items in view, she says that these are Mrs. Manstey's real friends. Now, typically, people consider themselves friends because they share common interests. The big thing that all of these residents of the yard and Mrs. Manstey have in common is that none of them interact with one another. The plants don't interact with each other. There's no indication that the parrot interacts with someone. The description of the doctor lends itself to the idea that he too is alone studying, and although the maid feeds the cat, there is no indication that there is any other form of interaction between the two of them. This is very much like Mrs. Manstey, because although she does talk to those who visit her, she doesn't seem to care about partaking in any meaningful interactions. Finally, I'm going to ask myself, what does the author want me to think about this character? To answer this question, I'm going to look at each section separately, and I'm going to use a sticky note to keep track of my ideas. In this first part, the word lonely really stands out. I think this shows that Mrs. Manstey is an introvert, a person who prefers being alone. She is happy being isolated with only her view and thoughts. She does not need human contact to bring her happiness. Regarding the second section, I think that by using the phrase real friends, Wharton wants her readers to see Mrs. Manstey as delusional. Most of the items mentioned are inanimate or non-living, and the real people don't even know Mrs. Manstey. We know that they don't see her as a friend because when Mrs. Manstey is on her deathbed, none of them go to visit her. I think Wharton wants us to view Mrs. Manstey as a little crazy. Recognizing this character quality now is crucial for understanding the plot and theme of the text. That is why examining the setting in great detail at the beginning is so important. So when we are trying to figure out how an author uses the description to develop a character, we can follow these three steps. First, we will reread a portion of the text and highlight words and phrases that describe the setting. Then we will ask, how do these descriptions relate to the character? And finally, we will ask, what does the author want me to think about this character? In this lesson, you have learned how to analyze character development by examining the impact of setting.